solve for x. I have 1/4 times x plus 1, and then minus 6 equals 2. I'm going to show you another way to solve this type of a problem. What if I add 6 first? Let's see what happens there. I get 1/4 times x plus 1 equals 2 plus 6, which is 8. So I decided to add 6 instead of distributing the 1/4 just to show you another way to solve. And I wanted to show you this method because the more methods you have, sometimes you can decide for certain problems you want to use one method or another one. It's like another little item in your math bag of tricks, if you will. So now to get rid of this 1/4 and multiply by 4 over 1, which is the reciprocal on both sides. And I'll put the times 4 over 1 here also. So 4 times 1 is 4, 1 times 4 is 4, makes 4 divided by 4, which is 1. And that means that this is all gone now. So I'm going to have x plus 1 equals 8 over 1 times 4 over 1, which is just 32. Then subtract 1, x equals 31. Let me check the answer on the calculator. Okay, so I'm going to input just as written, 1 divided by 4, then open parentheses, and for x I'm using 31, and then plus 1, close parentheses, then minus 6, and if this 31 is correct, it should equal the 2. And it does, so I know that x equals 31 is correct. So I would really recommend doing this. I mean, especially with these complicated equations with rational numbers in them, use the calculator to check your answers. It takes about a minute, and it'll give you 100% confidence in whether your answer is right or wrong. And I think it's really worth a minute to get that confidence in your answer.